You want to solve a linear program such as this one, you see that sometimes we have equality constraints, less than or equal constraints, some of them should be non-negative but not all of them, and this is a little bit a mess because you have many different cases to deal with. And so we prefer to put this linear program into a very canonical form that we will call the standard form. Okay, the standard form is a form of the linear program in which you have only less or equal constraints, and all the variables should be non-negative. The good news is that it's always possible to convert a linear program into the standard form. Let's look at this example. Okay, you see that it's a little bit a mess. We have an equality constraint, we have less than or equal constraint. And one way to get rid of this equality constraint is first to replace this with two constraints. One will be less or equal to 7, and the other one will be larger or equal to 7. Okay, so you replace this by two constraints. The other problem that we have here is that in the standard form, every variable should be non-negative. And so to avoid that problem, we will replace the variable x2 by x2 prime minus x2 prime prime, two fresh new variables, and this one should be non-negative. Okay, so every time you meet x2, you replace it by these two ones, and you impose that these two ones should be non-negative, and that will put the linear program into what we call the standard form. Another form is what we call the slack form, okay? And this is one step further in the transformation. It's a form in which you only have non-negative constraints that are inequalities, but all the other constraints should be equality constraints. For instance, this is not allowed in the slack form, okay? And so to replace this constraint with an equivalent equality constraint, we will say that bi minus this is equal to a new variable here, okay? And this will be what we call a slack variable. Of course, if this slack variable is equal to 0, it means that it's equivalent to have an equality here, and we say that the constraint in that case is tight, okay? The inequality is tight. But you always have a way to transform an inequality constraint into an equality constraint, like this one, by introducing a slack variable such as this one. Okay? So that's the standard form. Equality is everywhere, and for all the variables, they should be non-negative. Let's look at the transformation. So it will be in two steps. First, we have this very general form. We convert it to standard form. Okay, as announced, I will replace x2 by x2 minus x3, okay, two variables here, such that all of them are non-negative. This one will be transformed into two inequality constraints, less than minus 7, but this is equivalent to this. Okay, and so now I have the standard form, and then I will convert that into the slack form by introducing my slack variables here. Okay, and this is a nice slack form that we have here that is ready to be processed by the simplex algorithm. And so my slack form is fully described by the tuple NBAB small b small c small v, okay, in which A is equal here to the matrix of the coefficients that you have. Okay, so if you take this, you've got the matrix of coefficient. C will be the vector of objective coefficients. Okay. And B here is what we have. So this vector 8 for 18 will be the constants that you have here. Okay. And so the linear program is fully described by this tuple of matrices, variables, and vector of coefficients.